Hallelujah. Praise God. For another day. Hallelujah. Beginning of another week. Just praise God for his goodness and how he's blessed us. Hallelujah. Feel blessed? Hallelujah. He has blessed us. He is good. That's good. Hallelujah. Lord, we come before you. We just thank you. We pray, God. Lord, we say we love you, Lord. We love you, God. Lord, because you first loved us. Lord, we thank you. Lord, all the blessings that you bestowed upon us, we thank you, God. We thank you that you're the lifter up of our heads, oh God. Hallelujah. We thank you, God. You're the joy of our salvation, Lord. You're the rock on which we stand, God. And so we thank you, Lord, that you are the lover of our soul, God. Yeah. And so, Lord, we invite you in, hallelujah, to have your way, God. Have your way. We want you to be pleased with what we do today. We want you to enjoy it, God, because it says that you smile over us, God. So we thank you, Lord. That's an exciting thing, God. We want to make you happy, God. So, Lord, we thank you for the angels, even that are around us, God. We know that there are angels all around, God. And so we pray, Lord, have your way, Lord. We come, we need to hear from you today, God. We need to hear from you. So, Lord, hallelujah. We say, take your rightful place, oh God. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Lord, you are worthy of all of our praise. You are worthy, oh God. And so we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Can we all Thank you. To the family, they get off. And And I'm gonna say, Lord, what he said, it has its purpose, and its purpose just do it. So I just thank God for how he just smoothed over all the rough edges. And it was a beautiful. And he had his way in the city. And I said, it is well with my soul, and it was people really to see.
Praise God. God answers prayer. Hallelujah. And so when he does, he wants to hear us say,
hallelujah.
We want to keep Reverend Lawrence Williams in prayer. He's ministering this morning. And so we want to keep him in prayer that God would have his way.
Amen.
Yes.
Reverend West. We can pray for him and his family. They come down with COVID. And so we know he's already having some difficulties in breathing in the last week. So we want to keep him in prayer. And we have to keep in prayer about COVID. There's things still going around. And we just thank God that people are recovering from it.
Thank you, Jesus.
And that God is blessing us, so keep him in prayer. And some of the other requests. Some of the members that we see with the prayer that God would continue to bless them. He knows what they need. And
he's a good God.
He's a good God. And so we're going to have a prayer hymn, and then we're going to go to God in prayer. Amen.
Thank you.
Let's go to this one great moment right now. God, for just you being you, God, beginning to the end, that it. right now. I pray for special blessings in the life of all the ministers and everyone here, God. We pray, Father God, that you continue to have your God-like way in the service, because it is well with all of our souls because of what you've done on the cross, Lord God. The fact that you rose on the third day, Father God, it is well with our souls. John 3:16 reminds us that God, you loved us so much that you gave your only begotten Son, so that whosoever believes in him will not perish. You will not perish and go to hell, but have everlasting life. You can, so we may have life and have life more abundantly, aka life and a whole lot more life, Lord God. So we thank you for that in the name of Jesus. We ask that you continue to bless this service in a special way. And in Jesus' name we pray. We ask that you touch the children today in a special way, Father God. Touch the saints, the elders in a special way, in the name of Jesus. Touch everyone in a special way. God, I pray that nothing comes to distract what you have to do today in this service, Lord God. And we thank you for everyone and all you're doing and more. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Father, I come before you, O God, to give a touch and an offering to you, O God. We
pray, oh God, you bless us, oh God. Bless those that give, oh God, those that have not to give, oh God. Pray, oh God, that one day they get to be able to give, Father. As we get the heroes back on to you today, thank you, God. Amen.
Let's all stand.
March 16th. Does anybody remember what that date is and what we're celebrating? That's right.
20 years.
That's right. 20 years. And it's worth being celebrated.
Amen.
I'm asking, we have deadlines to meet. We're not having it here, so we're having it at the Hilton. So there's deadlines for us to meet, such as how many people, money to be turned in. We cannot pay at the door. We must have the money in. I'm asking you to please, if you're going, see to it that I get your cash, check, money order, Zelle, Cash App by the end of this month.
Amen.
We're asking you to please be timely in that so that the pastor's aide won't be stressed out trying to get everything in place and have it as a nice celebration, because that's what we want. We want to honor our pastor for 20 years of service to our church and our church family.
Yeah.
And he's been faithful, and we want to be faithful in everything that we do for him. I appreciate your cooperation. If you need a flyer or to help you remember, I have flyers. So sometimes we need to see it. So that you can see what's going on and be mindful of it. Remember, by the end of this month, it's $80 per person. That includes your lunch and the gift for the pastor. $50 for children. And one other note is CWC is asking you to wear Afrocentric attire, something, on next Sunday, which is the last Sunday of the month, celebrating Black History.
Amen.
That's another next Sunday, Afrocentric attire to celebrate Black History Month. I thank you so much for your cooperation.
And we know that we are celebrating Black Black History all month, and we thank God for all that has happened. And today will be no different. We have something special in store. We will have CJ Bolger, and he's going to do original Black History rap. So let's give him a hand clap. All that, like, we can do better than that. Let's give him a hand clap.
All right, what's up, Asst? If you're happy to be in the house of God or on Zoom or in church, make some noise! All right. My name is CJ, and today I was asked to do this song by my dad because we believe someone needs to hear this song today. And my song is about how no matter what you're going through, you can overcome it because we are overcomers. In the Bible, in Romans chapter 8, it talks about how we are born conquerors through Christ Jesus. Plus, in this song, I want y'all participation in it. So when I say, let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer, I'm going to point the mic out to y'all. And I want y'all to say, overcomer. Let's practice it a couple times. Let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Let's talk to the song.
Ready?
Let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Sometimes it's like digging a slump. You feel lower than a thump. But see, I'm an overcomer. Any chance come my way, I beat it like a drummer. Because I can do anything I put my mind to. It's even design my own shoes, see? Why can't I get a gun to your way? But it's how you approach it each day, see? Sometimes it's gonna make you sad, man, or even make you feel bad, but look, you gotta keep going. Just like the QB, you gotta keep throwing. Yeah, you can't quit the first step. You gotta stand up. You gotta pray. Everything is better done God's way. So God can help you the best way. Yeah, I'm more than a conqueror. Any chance come up with, I'm a monster. Any chance come up with, I can overcome it. So better be sure I ain't gonna run. Even if it's raining in the summer, let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Yeah, we gonna rock our school colors to let the world know we're overcomers. Yeah, even if it's raining in the summer, let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Yeah, we gonna rock our school colors to let the world know we're overcomers. Yeah, we gonna break our school colors to let the world know we're overcomers. Yeah. Sometimes class is too hard. It feels harder to try and get you for the Bell Boulevard. See, the overcomer can't keep you. It may make you feel queasy. See, school is a challenge. It's a lot of work. You gotta balance. See, with Christ, anything is possible. But you gotta be your barbering to God. See, school can be rough. These essays are really tough. See, one day I ain't doing that great. My stomach felt like it was about the due date. And I had work that was close to the due date. And I didn't really feel like doing it. God got me through. Even when I felt like I couldn't do it. So I'm giving God all praise. Is he the one that helped me through my day? Even in this rainy, in the summer. Let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Yeah, we're going to run our school colors. So let the world know we're overcomers. Yeah. Even if it's raining in the summer, let me hear you say, I'm an overcomer. Yeah, we gonna run our school calendars. Let the world know we're overcomers. Yeah. All right, no matter what you're going through, no matter what situation you're going through right now, no matter if it's physical, financial, mental, emotional, you can overcome it. Because our God is bigger than the obstacle. So on three, I want everyone to say, I can overcome anything. Uno, dos, tres. I can overcome anything. Thank you. Now, the senior of the hour, give a clap for my friend, Cornelius Bolger, senior.
overcomer.
Hallelujah. Let's give him another hand clap.
But I just want to say, before I sing this song, it brings it more home. Jesus went to his hometown in Mark, the 6th chapter. He went to his hometown in Nazareth. And he went to synagogue, and many people said, "Isn't that Jesus, your son?" And his brothers are this one. And we know all of them are these sisters. And then they said, "Where did this man get these teachings? And what is the wisdom that is given to him? And where did he get the power to do miracles? He is just a carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James, Joseph, Judas, and Simeon, and Simon." And Jesus answered and said, "A prophet is honored everywhere except in his own home."
My Lord.
So Jesus was not able to work miracles there except to heal a few sick people by putting his hands on them. He was amazed at how many people had no faith.
Isn't my Lord. Something? My Lord.
He went up. Millions, probably in a day, thousands and thousands. But his people, where he came from, had no faith, and very few were healed. I'm going to say this because it ties in, like you see, it's a spiritual, but it reminds us that sometimes in our own home, we're not welcome. And sometimes people really don't believe in what the power of God and what he's done in us. But we're overcomers.
Amen.
Thank you,
amen.
CJ.
Amen.
Thank you. We are overcomers. Praise God. Thank you. But Jesus said to them, "Father is honored everywhere, except his hometown. And with his own people and in his own home." So Jesus was not able to work any miracles there except to heal a few sick or put him to the mountain.
High Street again, young man. Good to have you. And church, everybody say welcome, please.
Welcome.
Well, don't say the please part. So just say welcome again.
Welcome.
Awesome. Good to have all of you here today. We know how the weather is up and down, and Punxsutawney Phil seems to be right this year. So it's not going to be the worst of winters, but it's going to be over today. So it's still winter. It's still only February. Still only the best month, so we can't get rid of it so fast. So let it go slowly. But good to have you here. And now I want to introduce to you and welcome to our pulpit, Reverend Cornelius Bolger, also known as Scenario. So as he comes, give him a warm applause. And we're gonna try to make this Cornelius proof here. So we move into things the other way.
We give God some praise. God. Give him a little bit more praise than that. I feel like God has done a lot for us today. He's done a lot for us this week. Give him a little bit more praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you. We're overcomers, right? We're overcomers? Where are my overcomers at? I got any overcomers in here? All right. I want to say something, and it's such. I know we are in a house where everybody is such a deep theologian, and I know I don't have to say this, but I'm going to say this. We understand that this is February, and this is what we have been deemed as Black History Month. We are aware of that, right?
Amen.
But just a reminder. Whenever we open our Bible, it shows us our people as well. Every time we open this word, you're getting history into your people, into who we are as a people, where we came from as a people. It started in Africa. Does anybody know where the Euphrates River is located? When you open Genesis, when Jesus was, when God was talking, it speaks about the Euphrates River, the land of Cush. The last time I checked, gold was there and everything. Remember, that gold was good. The word says, right? That gold was good. So every time we open our word, we are getting a history into our people. Now, before we get into the word today, I just feel led to say something. And I'm going to say, listen, now I want to speak directly to the senior citizens in the house, the youngest people in here. Every senior citizen in here that knows that they are sitting in High Street Church of God and how they got here today, can you make me cut back in? Every senior that knows that they're sitting in High Street Church of God, you know how you got here. Now this is another thing. Let me take it one step further. That knows at least the words of one hymn. Clap your hands. I need to know all the words, the complete words, to one hymn. Clap your hands. So you know what that means? You know exactly where you are, and you know the words to one entire hymn, meaning that you still have a great memory.
Amen.
That means you still have a great memory. We don't speak Alzheimer's and dementia over anybody in the house of God. Your memory is good. The Bible says that life and death is in the power of the tongue, and those who love it shall eat the fruit thereof. So we don't speak death over the mind. You have your memory, and healing is there. God's going to be restoring some people's thoughts this week. And we want testimonies next week. We want testimonies next week. Now, I'm not done. How many people in here? Everybody does, for everybody. How many people in here know the words to, now look, I'm looking at this, I'm digging some people's business. Before you were saved and after you saved, how many hands? You know what that means? Now let's think about the time length of a song. A song is about, depending on the era your song comes from, that song is between maybe 7 minutes, 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 3 minutes, 2 minutes, and if we get down to the TikTok errors, it's just less and less. But the songs, they got time. Think about this, right? What if you know 7 minutes of your favorite song? Just think about what if you dedicated to learn 7 minutes of scripture to your memory? 7 minutes, the Bible says to hide the word in your heart. Be prepared to give a man an answer about the hope that lies within us. And guess what? This is the thing. If you dedicate the time, it's not on you. Because all you have to do is put it in. And last time I checked, there is a special custodian inside of us called the Holy Spirit. So when we need these scriptures, it's his job to bring it to our mind when we need it.
Yes.
It's his job. We just have to put it in. That's all we have to do. I want to encourage us to put it in. That's all we have to do. Now, as we did, the word before the word today, and we're going to get into the word in a second, but the word before the word for High Street Church of God today, Philippians 3:14. I press toward the mark of the prize for the higher calling of God in Christ Jesus. High Street Church of God, continue to press. Keep moving forward. Don't stop in the middle. Keep moving forward. I just want to be a brief word of encouragement there as well. Now, if you have your tablets or your iPhones, or if you have the Bible, for us that hold the physical book, it's time to hold the physical book and turn to the Word. And today the Word comes from 2 Timothy chapter 1. And we're focusing on verse 7. And I'll be reciting this and quoting this from the King James translation of the Bible. When you have it, you can say, I got it, Reverend.
Got it, Reverend.
All right, all right. All right, all right. All right. All right. So 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, we see the Apostle Paul, a spiritual father, is talking directly to one of his spiritual sons, Timothy, because we know that Titus is also one of Paul's spiritual sons. But in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, and one of what is called one of the pastoral epistles, the Apostle Paul is talking to Timothy, and he says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind." Somebody needs that one more again. "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and reciting of his word. Let's pray. Lord, Father God, we love you. We thank you, God. God, we know that you have a word today, and you've come to do a whole lot. You've done a whole lot already. God, we ask, Father God, we thank you for everyone who has worked in the service, God. Minister Karen, Lord God, Pastor Linda, Pastor Griffin, everybody who was up here today ministering, Father God, being a blessing as you bless them, Lord God. Now, we ask that you bless the word, as that I decrease so you can increase, God. They don't need to hear none of me. They need to hear all of you. We ask that you hit what you need to hit, equip what you need to equip, God. Do what you need to do today in the house of God. And we thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, church, I want to talk to us about one of the biggest enemies of purpose that has ever existed. If we allow it, it will take us captive. Yes. It will keep you bound and chained in a way where the freedom that Jesus Christ has promised us will not fully, truly be experienced until we are free. It is a bully to dreams. Yes. It stifles your vision. It makes doing ministry or building your ministry or building your kingdom business or building your kingdom company an afterthought. It makes you flee from positions that God has placed you in. I'm talking to somebody. It makes you flee from positions that God has placed you in. It makes you stay where God's telling you to leave longer than you should. If we allow it, it will block opportunities and make us comfortable living a life that's small and insignificant compared to the life that God has called us to live. Today, church, I want to talk to us about the spirit of fear. The title of this message is The Elements of Fear, Part 1. It's only part one. It's a foundation. This is a foundational message. It's laying a foundation today. We know in the Bible, the Bible primarily speaks of two types of fears. It primarily speaks of two types of fears. The first fear that the Bible speaks of is the fear of the Lord. And just so we're clear on that, I'm going to break that down today just so we understand what the fear of the Lord actually is. The next fear that the Bible speaks of is the spirit of fear. And that's what we're going to focus on today. But just so we're clear on what the fear of the Lord is, I'm going to break that down right now. See, the fear of the Lord, you have your Bibles? You have your Bible? The fear of the Lord is what we see in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7, where it says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. For fools despise wisdom and instruction." Are you with me? Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. "For the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. For instruction." See, when we apply the knowledge of God, aka use the knowledge of God in our lives, that makes us wise, because wisdom is knowledge applied. Wisdom is knowledge applied. See, the fear of the Lord is not lock your doors when you see Jesus or hide under your bed when you hear the name Yahweh. No. And especially if you are a follower of Jesus Christ, if you are a Christian and you have accepted the sacrifice that Jesus Christ made on the cross for the entire world, that means that you have been reconciled to the Father. Reconciled means friendly relationship has been restored between us and God. So it's definitely not lock your doors when you see Jesus. It's come on in, friend. See, the fear of the Lord is to have deep reverence and respect for God. See, if I have deep reverence and respect for God, that means I live a life that shows that I have deep reverence and respect for God. Meaning I regard God's word in my life. Meaning I live my life by God's word. And I don't live live a life that contradicts and conflicts God's word. See, the fear of the Lord, see, the fear of the Lord is to have deep reverence and respect for God. Because when I live a life that has deep reverence and respect for because if we ever to get outside of the will of God, the Holy Spirit will raise up a feeling of mourning, which produces a healthy fear, which serves as a GPS to show us that, hey, God on course. And that healthy fear, if we're obedient, will serve as a GPS to guide us in, under, and back, all around the will of God for our lives. See, parents, when parents raise their children, when they train them in the way that they should go, so when they're older, they don't depart from it. They are raising them in the fear and the admonition of the Lord. If you are raising your child in the fear and the admonition of the Lord, you are raising them in the fear of the Lord. If you are raising them in the fear of the Lord, you are raising them to have reverence and respect for God. And when you raise your child to have deep reverence and respect for God, if they ever should end up where they ain't got no business being, the Holy Spirit in them will raise up a feeling of warning that will produce a healthy fear. And they will hear your voice and the word of God that you taught them so well. And that healthy fear will produce a healthy fear that they have not on course. And if they're obedient, they will lead them back in, under, and all around the will of God, and back home or wherever they're supposed to be. Yeah. Oh, yeah, are you with me today?
Yeah.
I encourage you. The grandparents and the parents. Grandparents, remind your kids.
Yeah.
Parents, raise your children and be of the Lord. Because when you raise them and be of the Lord, your faith and God's word serves as a GPS to guide them from where they don't need to be to where they do need to be.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me today?
Yeah.
Do we have a clear understanding of the Lord? Understand the fear of the Lord. We know Paul says, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. We know the fear that we're focused on today is the spirit of fear.
Yeah.
Spirit of fear. Now you're following. We know in life, there are things that we like to call situations that produce natural fear. Situations we like to say produce natural fear. We also in life have situations where people have things called phobias. How many people here got a phobia? A phobia, right? We also have what folk call common fears. What we call common fears. And today, this is what I want to deal with today. The Lord wants to deal with these three areas. Foundation. It got to get laid. What we call natural fears, what we call phobias, and what we call common fears. See, an example of what we deem as a situation that produces natural fear is, if you were inside of a bank, don't want to use you personally, but if somebody was inside of a bank to make a withdrawal or a deposit, and while they were inside of the bank, somebody came in to rob the bank at gunpoint. To get down on the ground, give me all your money. Right then and there, it would produce a feeling of fear, worry, anxiety, panic. But even if you are a Christian, you can pray inside of a bank robbery, and God will give you peace that passes all understanding. But it would be what we deem as natural for you to feel a feeling of fear at first. Be natural. Another situation that produces what we call natural fear is if you are a parent or a guardian. I'm talking to somebody today. I'm going to have you come up this pulpit.
All right.
If you are a parent or a guardian and you had an argument with your child because your child don't like the fact that you are raising them in the fear and the admonition of the Lord, they don't like the rules.
Yeah.
So because they don't like the rules, one day when you send them to school or to the store or wherever you sent them, they decide to run away, not come home. Right then and there, they will produce a feeling of fear, panic, worry,
anxiety. But even in that situation, prayer should be at the top of the list. Because God can give you peace that passes all understanding, even in that situation. But it would be natural for there first to be a feeling of fear. Now follow me. It's understandable. Why is it understandable? Because both of these situations are situations that produce trauma. They produce trauma. But it's because of the trauma, and there needs to be healing from trauma. Sometimes it's a process, but there needs to be healing from trauma. But if you want to say, because you were in that bank robbery at gunpoint, that since you were in that bank robbery, you will no longer go to the bank to make withdrawals of deposits. And because of that, from now, you now do keep all your money at your house. You now bank at First National Mattress and United Shoebox. That trauma has allowed the spirit of fear to come take you captive, and today God wants you free.
Yes, He does.
He wants you free. Now, it's understandable if you're a parent and your child runs away from home, if you feel fear, but when that child comes back, because they're coming back, when that child comes back, if you say, well, now, because the child don't like the rules, you are afraid because of that trauma. You are afraid to raise your children and the fear and the admonition of the Lord. And if every time your house is quiet, that trauma raises up. Because when your house is quiet, you have a fear that run away again. You have allowed that trauma to open the door for the spirit of fear to take you captive. And today, God wants you free. He wants change. He wants change off your life today. See, situations that we call natural fear are situations where the fear comes through trauma. See, it's fear produced through traumatizing situations, which opens the door for the spirit of fear. And if we allow it, the spirit of fear will take us captive. If we allow it. Somebody said, come down my bowling lane, preacher. That's fine. You have some folk who have experienced trauma in relationships. In relationships, and because of the trauma that they experience in relationships, they have allowed the spirit of fear to take them captive. Now they are afraid to get close to people because somebody that they were close to hurt them. I mean, deeply hurt them. I mean, hurt them badly. And that brought trauma. And that trauma opened the door for the spirit of fear. Now it is taking them captive. Now they are afraid to build healthy, happy, godly relationships with people. And they are afraid or scared to death to get close to folks. But I came to tell you today that that feeling of fear to get close to people, that spirit is not from God, because God does not want us afraid to get close to people and build healthy, happy relationships. What God wants us to do is what it says in Proverbs chapter 4. It says to guard our hearts with all diligence, because out will flow the issues of life. Now listen, let me break that down. I pointed to my heart muscle. But he ain't talking about your heart muscle. Guard your thoughts and guard your feelings. Okay? Guard your heart, because out will flow the issues of life. See, God wants us to pray and watch for. He wants us to pray, Lord, show me who I can get close to and who I can't get close to. I'm talking to somebody in the back right now. Lord, show me who I can allow close to me and who I can't let close to me. Because God does not want you to be afraid to build healthy, happy relationships and get close to people. That's not God. You have some folk who have been taken captive by the spirit of fear for a very long time. I mean, a very long time. They haven't experienced true, genuine relationship in a long time. I mean, a long, long time. Long time. And because they haven't experienced true, genuine relationship in a long time, they have been upset. They have been miserable. They have been sad because they are afraid. Yeah. And build healthy, God relationships. But I want to say something. If that's not God, that spirit is not coming from God. And today, God wants you free from honey, can you come grab my hand, please? Come on down, you walk this floor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on down, thank you so much. Thank you. Give it up, my lovely wife.
Hallelujah.
A suitable helpmate. Hallelujah. And walk these floors. We know that situations that produce natural fear again are situations where the fear comes through traumatizing situations that open the door to the spirit of fear. And if we allow it, it will take us captive. And today, God wants us free from those bounds and chains. Somebody in here is chained up right now. And God wants you free from the spirit of fear. It's healing here today. It's healing here today. Don't let the enemy tell you otherwise. It's healing here today. It's healing here today. Healing it. Don't let the enemy put poison in nobody's mind on this side. It's healing here today. God has deliverance here today. We know in life there are things that we like to call common fears. Common fears. We have things that we call common fears. And listen, I don't have time to go over every common fear in the world. But one common fear that has been given to us by Harvard University is the common fear of large animals. How many people here are afraid of large animals? Afraid of large animals? Well, I don't just want to focus on large animals. I want to focus on large animals and animals in general, okay? Because there's a lot of people that say, oh, it's common. We're going to be afraid of large animals. That's a common fear. Some people say that it's normal to be afraid of large animals and animals. Some folks even say that it's natural to be afraid of large animals and animals. Well, guess what? Even though it's normal and natural to us, it is not normal or natural to God for us. Why? Because it is not normal or natural to God for us to be afraid of what he gave us authority and dominion over. That ain't normal to God for us. Ain't normal. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, God the Father, God the Son, Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit, three in one, the Godhead, said to himself, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let us give them dominion over the fish of the sea, the fowl of the air, the cattle, all that is in the earth, and every creeping thing that creep upon the earth. See, it is not normal or natural to God for us to be afraid of what he has given us dominion over. Somebody got to hear that a little bit deeper. I need to go somewhere else with that. I need to go somewhere else. How many people know children are a gift from God?
Amen.
Children are a gift from God. To every parent that has a child, they are a gift from God.
Yes.
Listen, it is not normal or natural to God for parents to be afraid of the children that he's given them authority over. It's not normal to God. That spirit is not coming from God. I need us to understand that that's not coming from God. It is not normal or natural to God for us to be afraid of who he has given as a gift. You ever been afraid of a Christmas? You ever been afraid of a birthday gift? That ain't normal. That ain't natural. Ain't normal. And it's not normal or natural to God for us to be afraid of children. Now let me say the animal kingdom. See, it is not normal or natural to God for us to be afraid of what he has given us dominion over. That is a consequence of sin. That's a consequence of sin. Now, after sin, it's understandable. I'm not going to go chill with no lion. But guess what? That's not the spirit of fear. That's wisdom. I ain't about to walk myself over there and be no people sandwich. That ain't wisdom. That ain't wisdom. Is not coming from God. Even that spirit of fear and is not coming from God. That came from sin. And sin opened the door for all trauma. And that trauma opened the door for the spirit of fear. And the spirit of fear is what comes to grip and take people captive. But today, it's healing from it. Last is phobia. Hallelujah. It's like, I'm saying, the meaning of the word phobia, it was fear. Situation that brought you to fear in the first place. So it's fear produced through original threatening situation, transferred over into similar situations when oftentimes the original cause is forgotten. Sometimes you have to stop and ask God, Lord, show me what is the root to this phobia. Show me the root. Lord, show me what caused this phobia. In other instances, folk know good and well where that phobia came from. They know good and well. I'm talking to somebody in here today. Folk know good and well where that phobia came from. Somebody right now, you know exactly where that fear of the dark came from. You know exactly where it came from. It may have came from a childhood traumatizing experience. When you were a child, your siblings took you and put you in a dark closet and shut the door and locked it. And that produced the feeling of fear of the dark and tight places. A feeling of the dark and tight places. And that brought trauma. And that trauma opened the door for the spirit of fear. In other instances, you have some folk who, they don't know where that phobia of the dark came from. They don't know. They have no idea where it came from. Well, even though you have no idea where it came from, the spirit of fear is not only taking you mentally captive, spiritually captive, emotionally captive, physically captive, but guess what? It's also taking you financially captive. You may say, well, how is that? Because the fear of the dark makes you keep your lights on all the time, even at night. So because you keep the lights on in your house all the time, even at night, you have a very high electric bill. But how much money would you save if you allow God to remove the spirit of fear out of your life today? To remove the spirit of fear in that situation. Hold up, pause. Sometimes people have a fear, aka a phobia, of success. Some folk have a phobia of success. And when you have a fear of success, the enemy is not your biggest enemy. Your biggest enemy is you. Because when God opens the door, because God opens doors, when God opens doors and opportunities, because of that phobia of success, you will unintentionally, subconsciously, or intentionally sabotage yourself and not go through the doors because of your fear of success. Somebody today needs to have a little quiet prayer time in their head. Lord, am I afraid of success? Is this what's holding me back? Is my fear to succeed? Because having a fear of success is irrational. Because if God is calling you to do something, he won't leave you alone. He'll be with you while you do it. Sometimes folk have a fear of failure. They have a phobia of failure. And when you have a phobia of failure, it works like this. Because you are afraid to fail, when folk are afraid to fail, they do absolutely nothing. And when you do absolutely nothing, your phobia is, it becomes a reality. You fail. You fail because you've done absolutely nothing. And today God wants somebody to pray, Lord, do I have a phobia? Am I afraid to fail? Is this what's blocking me from getting to where you called me to be? Is this blocking me? Is this blocking me? Is it not the devil, Lord? Is it me? Is it me? And have no prayer time. See, whatever the phobia is, I want us to understand something. God did not cause the trauma that allowed the spirit of fear into our lives. Why? Because phobias are a hindrance to the purpose, plan, and freedom that God wants us to experience. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8, it says, wherefore he saith, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. We know this is talking about Jesus. But Jesus has taken captivity captive. Of these types of messages. Yes. You have some folk who have a phobia of these type of messages. And I want to encourage you, don't have a phobia of these type of messages. When these messages come, the spirit of fear tries to chain you up and chain you deeper and bind you up because they know that your healing and your freedom is here. Yes. Don't be afraid of these types of messages. Again, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8, it says that wherefore he saith, when he ascended on high, that he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Jesus took captivity captive. So whenever the spirit of fear has gripped us, Jesus can make it release us. And that's what I want to pray today first, that Jesus, whenever the spirit of fear has gripped us, that Jesus make it release us in his name. Next, I want to pray that God bring healing to whatever caused that trauma that opened the door to the spirit of fear in lives. I want to rebuke the spirit. I want to pray in Jesus' name, rebuke the spirit of fear out of High Street Church of God. It has no place here. It has no place here. And whatever the spirit of fear may be a presence by you, a believer, God can remove it. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you wouldn't be impressed by it. You would be possessed by it. But if you're possessed by it and Jesus Christ is not Lord and Savior over your life, I encourage you to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior over your life today. Because even if he prayed for you, it can leave. But without the Holy Spirit in you, it can come right back. And it can come back stronger than it was before. Because the Holy Spirit is the spirit that combats the spirit of fear. I want to pray against influences that we bring into our lives that feed us the spirit of fear. See, I can't. I'm not going all that yet. You know, I'm going to go into part two, but I'll answer part one. But we're going to pray against those influences as well. Because listen, today it's healing here. I want to pray with you. You come up here and take my hand because God has healing. For God does not give us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. We can pray right now. I'm going to pray. And if anybody wants personal prayer, I will take your hand and pray for you. God has healing here today. He has deliverance in you today. Somebody's been dealing with terrors and trauma. God has healing for you today. Healing is available today. Jesus has healing here. And I want to pray for us first as a whole. If anybody wants personal prayer, you can come grab my hand. Lord, Father God, we thank you, God. God, we thank you for your word, Lord. God, we thank you that you don't give us a spirit of fear. You don't give us a timid spirit or a coward spirit, Lord. You give us boldness. You give us peace. You give us gentleness, Lord God. You give us power. You give us love. You give us a sound mind. And today, Lord, whatever the spirit of fear has held on and gripped your children, God, we ask in the name of Jesus that you make it release them in your name. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. We ask, Father God, because you let captivity captive, you can break the chain, you can break the bond, you can let the captives free. That's what you say in your word that you came to do, to set the captives free. And today we ask that you set the captives free who have been chained and dealing with the spirit of fear for a long time. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray right now, God, that you bring healing to whatever caused the trauma in our lives that opened the door for the spirit of fear. God, walk somebody through their process, God. Hold their hand through the process to be free, healed, and delivered from the trauma that opened the door to the spirit of fear, Father God. I don't know if they witnessed a murder, Father God, but whatever brought their trauma into their life, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that you free them from it, that you heal them from it in the name of Jesus. But we pray, Father God, whatever the spirit of fear has tried to oppress your people, Lord God, that you remove that spirit of fear off their lives. It seems to follow them, Lord God. Just a fear, Father God. We ask that you set them free. God, right now, I pray against the influences. Some people watch the news way too much and feed themselves the spirit of fear on a daily basis. They go to sleep on the news. They don't go to sleep on your word. They go to sleep on that news, and it's just a healthy dose of the spirit of fear, Father God. But I pray, Father God, that you awaken your minds and your people and show them God is not giving that spirit of fear. You're also not telling us to watch the news before we go to bed. Go on to sleep on that, God. That's the spirit of fear influence in a lot of lives of people, Lord God. Let your word be the last thing that they meditate on at night. You tell us to meditate in your word day and night. Let that be the last thing that is meditated on by your people, Lord God. I pray if there's anyone in here who does not know you and the sound of my voice, if they are dealing with the spirit of fear and they don't know you, if that spirit has gripped them tightly, chained them up and bound them up and taken them captive, they don't even feel safe to walk the street without a gun. They don't feel safe because the spirit of fear is playing and torturing their mindset. I rebuke it. Relationship with you because healing here, so is salvation. Oh God, we thank you, Father God, for everything that you're doing. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If anybody wants prayer, right now, it's available. God has healing here today. Today there is healing here. So if anybody wants to come up right now for personal prayer, we can pray right now. Lock hands.
Lord Father God, Lord Father God, we give you glory, honor, and praise, Lord God. Lord God, we come to you right now asking you to remove the spirit of fear out of our life, Father God. Wherever anxiety tries to come in our life, Lord God, we ask that you remove it out of our life, Lord God. You tell us to be anxious for nothing, but to dedicate everything we pray in supplication. Let our request be known to you, and the peace of God will guard our heart by Christ Jesus, Lord God. Whatever anxiety tries to rise up, Lord God, you tell us the key to kill anxiety is to talk to you, Lord God. If
just continue to pray, and God will continue to remove anxiety, Lord God. We pray against fear, Lord God. With fear is trying to grip, Lord God. We rebuke it in the name of Jesus, God. We ask that you heal her from whatever she needs healing from, Lord God. Lord God, we ask, Father God, even private requests, God, that you just touch her private request, Lord God. God, we don't have to know, Lord, because you already know, Lord God. We ask, Father God, that you heal her in a special way, eradicate any area of fear, Father God, that is trying to grip her, keep her in temple, God. God, you have a calling for her to do things, Lord God, and the spirit of fear constant, torment the mind and come with different scenarios. And Lord God, we rebuke those things in the name of Jesus, God. We ask that you just speak to her those things that you say, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Just come. The power to move around and continue to be a blessing and a light of all the people who know her and the people who will soon meet her and know she is, Lord God. Yes. We thank you for healing, God. God, as she leaves from up here today, your healing virtue has went forward in her in the name of Jesus. And as she walks in faith, Lord God, she will continue to see your healing in her life, Lord God. We thank you, God. Lord, your word is breaking chains off her today, Lord God. We thank you for your word of deliverance, Lord God. Now, as she continues to walk in it and Holy Ghost boldness, she will see that the spirit of fear and grip her no more. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me give God some praise. We give God some praise. Healing is the children's bread. God wants to make sandwiches for all of us.
Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank the Lord.
How many of you wish you stayed home today?
Hallelujah.
I know you all wish it was a little warmer in here, but how many of you wish you had stayed home today?
Hallelujah.
What you got today, thanks for the one real brilliant, non-fearing young man that raised his hand, what you got today, you could not get from staying home.
That's right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
As much as I believe in the power of the Holy Spirit to use all the technology that exists out there, all of you on Zoom got only a hint of what we got today.
Hallelujah.
Just want you to know the presence of the Lord.
Presence of the Lord.
In this place.
Hallelujah.
Fear being removed.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Fear is not for the faithful.
No.
So we got to start walking in the authority that God has given us. Just to piggyback a little, I confess, I fear heights. But I tell you, I never allow the heights. I can think of maybe one occasion. Don't allow the heights to really rule me. Because I quote scripture to the heights. When I drive and I get to those bridges that are a little bit too high, especially that one just before the airport where the planes and you are on the same level, it looks like it. I know that I have no wings. I say, Lord, I'm in your hands. Take the wheel, guide me, lead me, direct me. And before you know it, he brings a song to me, whatever the song is. I'm singing a song and I'm going on the bridge. And next thing I'm back down and I'm solid, what I think is solid ground. And I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Fear is real, but God is bigger than our fear. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to ask my dear brother to pray for me. Because the Lord has delivered me from a lot of things. He's delivered me from a lot of fears. And I was fearful to go up there.
Father God, we just come. We thank you, God, for her courage, Lord God.
Yes.
We thank you for the courage to come forward, Father God. God, because you have healing for her today, Lord God.
Yes.
God, we ask, Father God, whatever area of her life that the spirit of fear is trying to keep her chained up and bound, taking her captive, we rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus, God. We ask, Father God, that you make it release her in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Touch her in her soul in a special way. God, let your power flow through her mind. Holy Spirit, speak to her right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And let her know, Father God, that fear has no place in her life, Father God. Fear tries to come and shut her down from her assignment, God. For God, we rebuke it in the name of Jesus, Lord God, because any assignment that you give, you are there with us as we do it. You will not leave us or forsake us, Lord God. God, without you, it ain't possible in the first place, Lord. So we thank you for being with her and going with her right now, Father God. As you break the chain of fear off of her life, Father God, she is a bold woman of God, Lord God, a bold servant of God, Lord God. These are the things you say about your woman servant, Lord God. So we ask right now, Father God, that you break the spirit of fear, you break that chain, Father God, off of her life, Father God, to the point that whatever breaks her fear, she can laugh at. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All we have to do is believe.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Since it's tradition that we have a high street, we want to bless the man of God for going before, preparing the word, delivering the word. So we're going to ask the ushers to serve you at this time. And as they serve you, we again, you know, I'm always amazed that this brother did not allow the fear of lack of sight to stop him from doing anything.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for a wonderful word that we received today.
Ask him what his financial address is.
What's your capital? Dollar sign scenario one.
Check right
there. Dollar sign scenario one. And you see if it pops up on the screen.
S-C-E-N-A-R-I-O.
S-C-E-N-A-R-I-O. Scenario one.
Okay.
Dollar sign first. Dollar sign scenario
Thank you.
One. Amen.
Yeah.
Okay, let's stand to our feet as we look to go. We just got a call that our dear Mother Williams, Sister Joyce's mother, had a fall. They say she's okay, but
oh, Jesus.
We don't, you know, at 97?
Yes.
At 97, because this is January, gone. 97, we do not accept falls as just by the way thing. So yes, she's okay. And of course, stay away from anything else that might come. We want to pray any fear that might come upon her, because you know, those are what does the word tell us today, right? How we get fear. So having fallen, we don't want her to know to develop fear so that she never walks again. You know, and that she keeps the light on all night and run up the electric bill. That was the brother said, right? You know, you got all that fear of darkness. You know, so we want to remember her in prayer. Lord, we come to you on behalf of our own talent.
Yes,
Lord. Daughter who has and made servant who has served you and is blessed by you to have lived 97 years.
Yes.
Now, Lord, in her 97th year, we pray that you were now in her 98th year, we pray that you will bless her. Continue to protect her and provide for her. Pray that this fall has absolutely no effect on her body, on her being, on her psyche, on her living. We pray away all fear. We pray away all hurt. We pray away all bruises. We pray away all of the enemy's attempt. Because she's in your hands. Thank you for protecting her. Thank you that even though she fell, she got up. Sometimes we fall, but she got up. So, Lord, we thank you for the power that you have given to her, that she was able to get up and to stand up and to be up and to walk again and to share your love and your word with those that she comes in contact. Lord, we pray for Sister Joyce and the rest of the family that you will also not allow any fear to come upon them. So we pray away fear, Lord, today. Today is a day where we rebuke fear, where we send it where it doesn't come to any fruition within the lives of your saints, Lord. It has no power or dominion over us because we have authority, because it didn't come from God. He did not give us the spirit of fear. He gave us a spirit of love. Give us a spirit of power. And give us a spirit of self-discipline. So, Lord, we thank you for who you are. Now, as we go several ways, take us home safely. Watch over us. Guide us. Keep us. Feed us. Bless us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Greet one another.
God bless. Hey, God bless you.
Thank you very much.
What number is that? What is that?
Boy, 722-299.